conference participants. Today, I'd like you to present our work on automated artificial intelligence-based knowledge assessment method based on reverse Turing test. Why do we care about automating assessment of knowledge? The first thing is that education is very important for economy. In fact, as this slide shows, there are few things that are more important than education. As studies have shown that improving education affect productivity of work and economic growth much more than change in equipment or similar investments. So if we could improve education just a little bit, it can result in it can have tremendous impact on economy. And there is no doubt that education cannot be better than the quality of our knowledge assessment methods. And there is a big problem because traditional methods are like taking exam using person-to-person method cannot be used on a scale. The demand is that we can administer something that is predictable, standardized, and that doesn't rely on having one person talking to many to assess their skills. And this led to ubiquitous use of multiple choice tests. And the understanding is growing that emphasis on multiple choice testing did significant harm because it favors rote learning and undermines students' engagement. Because if a student knows that he is going to pass multiple choice test as a knowledge assessment method, he has very little motivation to study material deeper. He knows that he won't be talking to a person to whom he can demonstrate his knowledge, and he basically can't impress computer with his depth, so he just need to know facts. But this is a big problem because companies need employees who can collect and analyze data, who possess analytical skills, and these skills are not trained by multiple choice tests and cannot be verified by multiple choice tests. So there was a significant growth in attempts to use artificial intelligence to automate knowledge assessment. And there is a bunch of existing methods. And first class of methods are focusing on automating of creation of multiple choice tests. And we know that multiple choice tests are not ideal method for testing knowledge. And it becomes even worse when multiple choice tests are created in automated way because our tools that create tests lack deeper understanding of the material, so we can't create test that has deep knowledge. And second class of methods, they are methods that attempts to grade free format answers, such as automated essay grading. But we can check grammar, we can check plagiarism, we can check to some extent topic adherence, but we cannot yet check deeper meaning of such essays. And therefore, with the tools, just make the problem deeper. We test surface knowledge and favor rote learning more. And what we want to develop methods that can be fully automated, but that can test deep knowledge. So what are possible solutions? So our idea is to use a reverse Turing test for knowledge assessment. And reverse Turing test is a variation of regular Turing test, where the roles of human and person are reversed. So CAPTCHA is a classical example of reverse Turing test. Our goal is to check the nature of the agent on the other side of the screen. Is it a person or is it a computer? And we're doing that by checking if the person possesses certain class of skills. And another version of reverse Turing test was used for diagnosing cognitive disorders. We put people to play games against computer, and by measuring their results, we can understand if people possess certain cognitive skills that are lacking in certain disorders. So there has been some work done, and our question is, can we make such a method more universal to test any type of knowledge? And here is the idea. So we take a generative model of some subject domain. The model that can generate objects that imitate results of human intellectual activity. This could be scientific papers, abstracts of scientific papers, textbooks, equations, tables, even images, basically anything. And we mix with the objects with real objects taken from database, and we ask person to distinguish between them. And know that given the fact that generative models are very advanced now, it is really hard to distinguish real object from artificial object. One particular kind of reverse Turing test for knowledge assessment is a language model based reverse Turing test. In this type of text test, the objects are fragments of text. So this is the example. Here we have two texts. One of them is taken from Wikipedia, and another is generated with language model. So which one is which? So how we can distinguish between these two texts? The grammar is already close to perfect, so we cannot distinguish basing on grammatical mistakes. So we need to use word modeling failures. So if we know the animal, hippo, we know that it doesn't have hands, much less long hands. It doesn't have two massive incisors. Another thing is that there is it is not the largest of all African big mammals. So we can if we know something about our subject, we can distinguish between these two texts. So of course this is a simple example. So many children would be able to solve this, but if you train the model on specialized texts, technical texts, then only our hypothesis is that only experts will be able to reliably distinguish between generated samples and real samples if we have short enough samples. So in this work, our goal is to test this hypothesis. And how this work is organized? So we took three different domains of knowledge: computer science, biomedical science, and food safety domain. It's a practical knowledge for restaurant workers. And we tested in which domain we compared results of several groups of people. So we compare results of expert group to students group and to people who have no domain-specific knowledge. So by design test in such a way, we hope to avoid bias, because if we just compare results of our method to, let's say, results of multiple choice test or regular exam, then we risk to, well, we risk to find no correlation, because just multiple choice test was flawed, or exam was subjective. But by comparing expert group with students group, with our choice of expert group is such that we guarantee that this group must know something about the subject area, and this knowledge must be higher than student group. So this removes subjectivity from study setup. So what we have found? So the first domain, computer science domain, the we generated examples using GPT-2 model, and we use context from real Wikipedia pages on HTML and networking, computer networks, and generated continuations based on that context. And then people were shown with the continuations, and they're asking to distinguish between real parts of articles and continuations. And for the first group that has about 30 participants, we found that expert programmers with 2 years of experience can answer our test with much better results than students. However, we found no correlation between students' grades and actual results of our test. So grades assigned to students by teacher were not There were no significant correlation between visa and results of reverse Turing test. So this could happen because our test group is small, but also it could happen because teacher has some biases about students. For example, when we ask it why particular students were assigned such and such grades, the teacher explained that they were assigned such grades for poor behavior and not for results of exams, not for your knowledge. In the biomedical domain, we compared three groups and we found that specialized knowledge given advantage to biomedical experts over students groups and software developers groups. So people with no biomedical expertise were actually software developers who were previously exposed to language model generated texts. And we basically know which flaws such models possess, which gives them certain advantage, could give them certain advantage over students. But the experts who possess subject domain knowledge but weren't previously exposed to such tests still have much better score, significantly higher score. So we can conclude that previous exposition to reverse Turing test, language model-based reverse Turing test, doesn't help people to achieve higher score than experts group who possess specific domain-specific knowledge. And having domain-specific knowledge is actually important to solve these tests. So we can't solve them just only by grammar or using logic. And final experiment was done with food safety domain, where we combine novice staff members and experienced staff members of the restaurant on their capability, their knowledge of food safety rules. And here we also compared them by checking the results of multiple choice tests. And we can say again that expert group have a much higher score, but novice and non-staff member seems to have similar score. So when we investigated why we have such results, we found that multiple choice test was not were not changed for a significant time. So people were asked to pass the same test again and again, and finally we learned answers to test questions in the novice group. But not having any practical experience resulted in the incapacity to answer, to find logical mistakes in texts, generated texts. While experienced groups, people that possess real practical experience, we were able to solve these tests much better. Our conclusions are that language model-based reverse Turing test can reliably distinguish between experts and non-experts in all three domains. And specialized professional knowledge is important because it results in higher scores than using only grammatical and logical consistency to analyze texts. We observed discrepancies between our results of reverse Turing test and traditional knowledge assessment methods. And we don't know why for sure. This is a subject for future investigations because we'd like to study larger groups. And finally, we found that people can't efficiently adapt to such texts to improve their results without possessing real knowledge. So, in my opinion, these are interesting findings because they point out to a new and interesting application, new approach for testing knowledge. And this new approach could be used to significantly improve knowledge assessment, because there is no need to be an expert in subject domain to create knowledge assessment tests using reverse Turing test. And even in such cases, there seems to be with the test seems to be a reliable indicator of subject's knowledge. So I think our preliminary study warrants more investigations in this area. Thank you for your attention.